and I haven't made a video in a while, but with the corona and everything was kind of slowed down for the year, and had to put up a tent so we can actually make videos. But we are starting to make videos again. Now I have a tent. I can stay out of the sun all day, and we can do what we promised for the summer and start making a lot more how-to videos. Today I'm going to show you how to carve an owl. It's kind of like a test here. But we'll show you how to do it step by step. And I'll show you a couple of smaller ones. I think it'll be a nice little project for you to start off the summer. I know I'm running late making videos, but with coronavirus and all that stuff, finally got a tent set up and starting to work for the summer. We're gonna start doing videos again. So I hope you enjoy it. Come and join me. I'll show you some examples of the other ones, and we'll get right to work and start teaching you how to make a nice little owl. Stay tuned. Now right here are some examples of some of the little owls we're going to make today. It's a pretty basic design. Right. And you can paint them. I'm just painting the eyes on these for now. But I'm going to learn how to cut the tails out and everything. And then you just paint them however you want, you know. But like I said, they're pretty simple. And if they crack, then we'll fix them with sawdust or whatever. Usually sawdust and glue is how you fix the cracks. And you get to see the detail we're going to put on. Right now I don't even have detail in here. This is just feather groups. Right. And that's how I want you guys to think when you're doing these. Is we make feather groups, not really each individual feather. So, let's get started. We're going to have to find a piece of wood. And then we'll be back. Okay, today we're going to be using the steel MSA-140C. It's a little bit of battery-powered chainsaw. I like it. It's lightweight. It's got a 10-inch carving bar on it. Quarter-pitch chain. And this right here is going to be to hold our carving. We're going to use the Rockwell jaw horse. I'm trying to explain everything as we go. This one's a little beat up. I've been using it for a while now. Love this thing. I'll put links in the description for anything I use for you guys. And let's go cut a log. Gonna need a piece of wood here. Got one out here ready. Let's see. Probably use this. Log, our saw, back in here we're making owls. Put that log up here, should be a good enough log. Okay. Oh, my dog's out. Chase. Hey, puppy. Bird dog. Where's the birds? Where are the birds? Huh? Where are the birds? He likes hunting birds. Alright, we're gonna come over here. Let's put the log. I'm trying to see best way to have the tail. I really kind of like to have the back swoop down for a tail, so we might make this the back. I'm gonna lock this in place. Should be good enough. You know, the idea of doing these owls is to make kind of like a diamond shape first, or a hexagon shape for the head, and then you shape your body. So what we're going to do is start there. Now if I'm going to make this the back, I'm going to have to make the front here. We're going to take an angle cut. Just like that. Get another one on this side. Try and get them fairly the same. Okay. I'm going to come to the back. Cut and shape a diamond. Like that. Okay. I'm going to slope the back. Front here, I'm going to make just a little bit of an X. And that's the diamond. Like that. Okay. This way we can take the eyes, put them where we want. Now I'm going to start shaping the bird before I do anything with the face. So I'm going to come down on the sides here. To get an idea of what the bird's gonna be like, you know, size-wise, before I even start. I'm gonna round this off. Give me an idea about how big I want to make them so I don't screw up the dimensions on the tail and everything. You shape them first. Get all that excess wood off so I can see where the owl's going to be. Just taking bark off so I can see what I got here. Now let's undercut here. Okay, around this.
We're going to come up here to the top. Those. Separate that little. Check this out right here. So that stands up. Now you can get the eyes over here by coming into the side like this. Trying to keep them rounded. Okay. Now, I like to make them fat and squatty, so I got to figure out where, how far down I want the body. And usually what I like to do there is start a wing first, because the head's going to come up. Okay, so I make a wing. I make one here. Okay. Where did I put my glasses here for a second? Now this helps me gauge everything. So once I make a V cut here, I can come down and figure out where I want to put the wing, and that'll help me establish where I want to put my body. Okay. Down straight down like that. And this wing. Come straight down like that and make your wing. Okay, we're gonna do this on the other side. This side, okay. The head's gonna get sucked into the wing. That'll help that stand out. Undercut the wing all the way around. We're going to undercut that wing. Thank you. Let's take it out. We're gonna make a beat. And we can take this down. Starting to shape up. Now we don't want too much more than this. We got to get a tail out of here. So what I'm going to do is clean this off quick. Figure out where we're going to put the tail, because then we can figure out the rest of the body where I want to cut it here. Otherwise, my dimensions get screwed up. So I'm going to start about here. Plunge that right in. Taking this cut all the way down because I'm going to cut that whole piece out so his tail hangs down like this big one over here. See here? The way his tail goes all the way down. So we're gonna cut all this out then. But then from the tail, we can figure out this cut right here. So he looks symmetrical. Don't mind all the boxes. I got all kinds of little carvings. They'll be going up to the flea market this weekend. So these boxes are full of them. Of course, wood chips and everything else. Okay. Now we'll clear the tail off. By the way, if you're using a jaw horse, don't ever hit this metal. It'll mess up your saw blade in a minute. Talking from experience here. We're gonna take here and cut the tail out. It's a good idea to put wooden blocks here, so if your saw does hit anything, you're hitting the wood and not the metal. Okay, now his tail's cut out. We can shorten that as we go if we want. Now I'll figure out the bottom half. See about what looks good. That looks pretty good. It'll be pretty symmetrical when I curve it in. Now that works. get the die grinder and whatever, it'll clean all that up. Now, under the beak, I like to make a heart. Round off his face, you know. Just like that. Now it's a matter of putting the wing detail and stuff on and rounding things over. That's pretty much the gist and the shape of our owl. Now to really get that tail to come out, I'm going to have to move the whole piece back. So let's undercut the face a little here. And detail and stuff you can put on with this or the Dremel. Okay, let me show you how I do a feather pattern here. And all this will get rounded over. But basically, what I'm gonna do is start here. Make a cut like that. And we're gonna get one here. And that's gonna be three feather patterns, three feather groups, right? And then we undercut all this with a saw or a sander, or whatever, and then you can put the wings on. The lines for the wings. See how that works? It's a lot simpler than trying to do each individual feather. And you just clean them up then and blend them together. When you sand it, it really comes out nice. The rough out stages of the owl. Just rounding everything and blending stuff together. One side done. Now we can do the same here. Make sure the wing's pretty pronounced. So back in the feathers here. For the tail. Anything I don't like, I'll shape up later. Separation. Just trying to get the shape of what I want. feather shaver. Try to keep these pretty much the same. Okay, now I gotta cut the tail out. So I'm gonna move this back. Hopefully this thing will grab just on the corner. Enough so I can cut that tail out. There we go. I'm gonna have to cut inside. I should be able to do 1 hour with this battery without recharging. Even one this size, which is pretty good size. I'm gonna cut straight through on both sides, but leave enough wood so I have a stand. Plunge through here. I'm gonna walk from side to side to make sure that it's gonna match. You don't walk through, you end up cutting through the tail on the other side. So you want to see where it goes and try and even them up, see how it's not quite. Even there. Not undoable. Okay. Alright, we pretty much got the shape of our. Haven't put any feet on them yet, but I don't know if I'm going to. Put some feathers on them. I'll do the eyes. Let's try the eyes. We'll use the tip of our saw here. Some of that out. Best we can do with the Dremel. Head's not too bad. A couple of feather groups here. Sweat in my eye. That's always good. Definitely a hot one. Let's see. Same thing though. You make your feather group and then you undercut it to make a stand out. Just clean up in here. Doesn't stick out enough for you. Cut it again. That's it. This is all going to be clean up with a sander. All shaping and rounding. We got ourselves our first owl. Hoping you guys can see all that with the light we got. I'm using the GoPro so it's a lot clearer than my little video camera. And I'll do another video on shaping them and cleaning them up. Or at least stop this here and recharge. Make sure my battery's charged up and we'll go to some other tools and we'll make this owl look a little more like this one. Okay, let me take a break, get a coffee, I'll be back. And some extra decal on this owl. And I'm using my little Proxon electric chisel for this. Thank you. fat little guy. Thanks for watching. I'll see you guys in the next video.